5 सेकेंड, 2 सेकेंड, रेडी एट द इंस्टेंस ऑफ द प्राइम मिनिस्टर वी हैड अ कैबिनेट मीटिंग टू डिस्कस दिस होल मैटर एंड इट वॉज हेल्ड एट 10 PM ऑन फ्राइडे द 16th September, द डे ऑन विच वी गॉट दिस मैसेज. द प्राइम मिनिस्टर फिक्स्ड द मीटिंग फॉर 10 o'clock एट नाइट बिकॉज मिस्टर रामा राव्स प्लान वॉज एक्सपेक्टेड टू रीच हियर अबाउट 8 o'clock इन द इवनिंग एंड इट वॉज थॉट दैट हिज प्रजेंस एट द कैबिनेट मीटिंग वुड हेल्प मी एंड माई कलीग्स इन कमिंग टू अ डिसीजन ऑन दिस वेरी डिफिकल्ट सब्जेक्ट. Unfortunately, the plane which brought Mr. Rama Rao was delayed by about 8 hours. He did not arrive here till early in the morning on Saturday. In the meantime, we discussed this question at the meeting of the cabinet on Friday night and having reviewed the subject from all angles, we came to the conclusion that in the circumstances there was no solution possible for the government of India except to devalue the rupee to the same extent as the pound sterling. I should like to say before I proceed any further that although the British Chancellor of the Exchequer had categorically denied that there was any intention on the part of the UK government to devalue the pound sterling, it occurred to me from such indications as I gathered in London that the possibility of the pound sterling being devalued was not altogether to be dismissed. Therefore, we arranged that our technical advisors in the Government of India here and our technical advisors in the Reserve Bank should at once set about an exhaustive and detailed examination of this whole problem, which they did. The result of this examination was that in case the pound sterling was devalued, we should devalue the rupee to the same extent. That same advice was given to me by Mr. Chintaman Deshmukh. In that opinion, the governor of the Reserve Bank fully concurred. We held another meeting of the cabinet on Saturday morning, at which the governor of the Reserve Bank was present and the members of the cabinet therefore had an opportunity so to speak of reassessing the position in the light of the account which the governor of the Reserve Bank brought to us of the whole position. We came to the conclusion that the best course was to devalue the rupee to the same extent. The meeting of the International Monetary Fund at Washington to consider the general revision of the exchange values of the currencies of all the member countries was being held on Saturday, the 70th, the day on which we came to our final decision. But I was informed by Mr. Chintaman Deshmukh that he was able to get the International Monetary Fund to postpone the examination of our case until Sunday so that we might have a little more time to examine the position. At 3 p.m. on Saturday, on the decision arrived at by the cabinet, I sent a cable to Washington to say that we would propose to the International Monetary Fund that the rupee should be devalued in the manner that we decided on. I wanted at that time to inform our neighbors, Ceylon and Pakistan, of our decision to make this proposal to the International Monetary Fund. But I could not very well do it on Saturday because Saturday was a business day, and I thought, in view of the great delicacy and secrecy attaching to this particular matter, that the earliest time when I could send a message safely to our neighbors was Sunday morning. On Sunday morning, therefore, I dispatched two telegrams, one to the Ceylon government and other to the Pakistan government, informing them that we were making this proposal to the International Monetary Fund. I would like to make a reference to Ceylon in this connection because my friend, the finance minister of Ceylon, immediately after devaluation was decided on both of this currency and of ours, made a statement in this parliament to the effect that he had not been consulted by the Indian government. I want to place before the House the facts in this connection. 2 days before, we received the message from Mr. Attlee because of the rumors which started all over the world regarding the possible decision of the UK government. The High Commissioner of Ceylon came to see me on the 40th, that is, as I said, 2 days before we received this message from Mr. Attlee, and he said there were all these rumors about devaluation, and in view of the close currency relations between Ceylon and India, he thought it was necessary that the two countries should act in consultation with each other. I entirely agreed with the view that he put before me, and I told him 2 things. First of all, the matter had not been formally and officially considered by our cabinet in view of the conclusions reached in the expert investigations that had been going on for long.